To start thinking about computer-aided design, let's start with an analogy. If I give you the works of Shakespeare to type up on your computer, would this make you a great author? No, it would make you a typist. Well, if you can use a CAD tool like NX to make pretty pictures, does this make you an engineer or a designer? At the lowest level of learning, you might follow the steps of a click-by-click tutorial, and voila, up comes up a 3D model, but you might not know what you did or why. The next higher level of learning might be to create a 3D model from 2D views. This gives you the features and dimensions of a part, but you have to figure out the clicks. Well, this still isn't enough. A higher level yet is to practice re-engineering existing physical parts. You have to figure out on your own what the features are and in what order they should be modeled, and measure the actual dimensions, and what parameters should you use to incorporate good design intent so that someone else can easily edit the model. Of course, your ultimate learning goal is to design parts to perform a given function from scratch. For example, you might have to design the upper spindle of the drill press to transfer the rotation of the pulley to the lower spindle with a sliding coupling. Unfortunately, these videos aren't going to teach you how to design, so let's spend our time thinking about re-engineering physical parts. Let's outline a general procedure to approach a model and think about simple ways to model it. Later videos in this series, hopefully, will demonstrate this procedure using specific parts from this drill press. Step one is to understand the function of the part. If you can't answer this question, you can't design it. What does the part do? Design a part based on its function. Don't just copy what you see. What methods are used to manufacture the part? Don't model artifacts of a specific manufacturing process. Step two is to understand the fit of a part. What are the mating surfaces to adjacent parts? These are the most important surfaces. These should be your primary datums. Model the part so that when you edit dimensions, these datum surfaces stay fixed relative to the datum coordinate systems. Step three is to determine the form of the part. What are the planes of symmetry or axes of rotation? Locate the datum coordinate system at the intersection of symmetry planes and datum planes to plan for symmetry. Look at the part from multiple views. What are the basic sections? Don't just look at the external edges. Look at the defining sections in the center of the part and the 3D shapes. Look for the section with the most detail to create the first shape to reduce the number of following features. Try to visualize 3D shapes in the part without edge blends. For example, look how different this part looks with edge blends suppressed. Focus on the internal solid shapes, not on the external edges. This drill handle looks extremely complicated at first, but as we study it, we can see that the handle starts with a simple shape with edge blends added to it. The upper part of the drill starts with a simple revolve. Relatively simple extruded 3D shapes are added and subtracted. Learn to visualize the internal shapes as if the blends were not there. What is your design intent beyond the current shape? What are the key dimensions expressing design intent? What dimensions are apt to be modified later? Think about creating expressions for these key parameters. Step four is to plan the sketches to create the basic shapes. Plan ahead to keep your sketches simple. For symmetric parts, sketch on a central datum plane instead of on faces. You might have to view the model with a static wireframe to see the sketch inside. Anchor the sketch to the origin, and it will remain fixed to that origin as you edit it. Sketch a region at a time to keep track of your constraints. Plan to select curves using region boundary curves or connected curves with stop at intersection. So leave the sketch untrimmed so that you can reuse it. For extruded sections, or extruded sketches, plan to use the extrude offset option. You can sketch open sections and not have to sketch the whole closed profile. For this tube, you can sketch one circle, not both the inner and the outer diameters. Step 5 is to modify the basic shapes with draft or shell. What features come before the shell operation and which after? Typically, add large radii, for example, before the shell. What are the drafted faces and what are the draft angles? Step 6 is to add detailed features such as bosses, ribs, and slots. Using the rib command, you can sketch a simple line that extends beyond the part. To create slots, sketch a simple line and extrude using a symmetric offset. Look for simple ways to model and combine features. Step 7 is to create holes. For fastener clearance holes, use the hole feature. To locate hole features, create sketches containing points. Sketch on faces because the hole location point must be on the surface to identify the start end of the hole. For precise holes, sketch and extrude a circle with tolerance information. Consider displaying the tolerance dimension as PMI. Step 8 is to add the final cosmetic edge blends and chamfers. Think about what selection intent option to use to select edges. For example, the curve rule of feature intersection edges will automatically select more edges when the intersecting features change. Blend short edges first to create ladder rungs, then blend the long tangent chains created by these ladder rungs. Again, combine blend features where you can. Don't forget that you can include different sets of blend radii in the same feature. Learning to see simply is an ongoing learning exercise. To be honest, I have modeled every part I show here several times as I see simpler and better ways to model them. If you see better ways yet, feel free to make suggestions in the comments below. I can't take credit for all the ideas presented here, so I thank those whose ideas I have borrowed. In summary, this is the general outline I will follow in this series of videos to think about designing parts. And this is also is the same general outline you should follow for thinking about what order you should create features. Function, fit, form, sketches, modify with shell and draft, detailed features such as ribs, bosses, and slots, holes, and lastly, edge blends and chamfers. Thanks for watching.